Welcome to Electromagnetics playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain you example based on Stokes theorem. And to have this session based on example of Stokes theorem, this is my question, where here function f has been given, where function f is equals to x square y into x direction plus x plus y square into y direction plus xy into z direction, and we are dealt with to solve surface integration of curl of function f, as well as we are dealt with to calculate line integration of function f, and this line integration, that is closed line integration of function f. So as per Stokes theorem, both of these calculations should be same. Now here one thing that I would like to suggest you, that is when this type of problem is coming in front of you, you should solve example of this line integration or surface integration by using this method. And answer for both will be same, but this calculation by having Stokes theorem using curl of function f, that will be easier one compared to line integration. Why? The reason is, in line integration, we need to integrate this function four times. As you can see, there are four different lines. So we need to integrate this function four times. So it will take a bit more time compared to this one. So I'll solve this by both of this method. So let us have first way of calculation, where I'll solve this surface integration by curl of function f. So let us solve first of all curl of function f. So what is curl of function f? So curl of function f, that is del cross f, and this del cross f, that is ijk del by del x, del by del y, del by del z, and function f, that is having x component, that is x square y, so I'm writing it over here, x square y, y component, that is x plus y square, so x plus y square, and z component, that is xy. Now see here, as per this integration, you don't need to calculate entire curl, but here I'll solve this entire curl and I'll tell you why don't we need to calculate entire curl. So let us solve this first. So see here, this will be I into del by del y into xy minus del by del z into x plus y square. So del by del z into x plus y square minus j into del by del x into xy minus del by del z into x square y. Plus k coordinate into del by del x into x plus y square minus del by del y into x square y. And if we solve this, then I into x is constant, partial differentiation of y, that is 1. So I into x and partial differentiation of z for x plus y square. So this is constant, so that will be 0. So x into I coordinate minus j into here del by del x of xy. So here x, y is constant, del by del x, that is del x by del x, that is 1. So this will be y minus del by del z of x square y. So this is constant, so that will be 0. So I can say minus j into y plus k into del by del x of x plus y square. So x will be 1 and y square will be 0. So 1 minus del y by del y, that is 1, and x square is constant, so 1 minus x square. Now see, why don't we need to calculate all three components? If you observe this line, then that is lying on xy plane, right? And it is there in anticlockwise direction. So as it is there in anticlockwise direction, as per right hand thumb rule, direction of this surface that is there, as per right hand thumb rule, you will be finding that is there in upward direction. If it is in clockwise direction, that will be in inward to the page, means it will be in minus z direction. But here this is in anticlockwise direction, so direction of this surface that is there in positive z direction, that is in outward to the page direction, right? So if you calculate dot multiplication of del cross f dot ds, then ds is there in z direction only, so z component that is this only, 1 minus x square, so this dot multiplication that will be 1 minus x square only, and this two component will be 0 as surface is not having direction in I and j direction, so dot multiplication of this two component will be 0. So now we need to do surface integration of this. Now here in this surface integration, we can clearly see x varies from 0 to 3 and y varies from 0 to 2. So here x varies from 0 to 3 and y that varies from 0 to 2. So if we do this calculation, so that has to be, see, this is what, 1 minus x square, and this surface is dx dy surface, where x varies from 0 to 3 and y varies from 0 to 2. Now let us solve this first. So if you do this integration with respect to x, then this will be x minus x square will be x cube by 3 dy, where limit for x is 0 to 3. If you place 0, then that will be 0. If you place 3, then this will be 3 minus 27 by 3, that is 9 dy. So this will be 6, minus 6. So minus 6 is outside, and integration of 1 is y, limit is from 0 to 2. If you place this limit, then this will be minus 6 into 2, that will be minus 12. So answer for this first question, that is minus 12. So see, this is easier one for you. Now I'll explain you how to solve this by four different line integration, right? By having this f dot dl. So let us do that step by step, so it will be more clear. So now see, first I'm considering this line as a first line. So let us say this is line number one. And in this line number one, y coordinate is 0. In this line number one, y coordinate is 0. So I'm saying y is equals to 0. You can see. So we can say dy is equals to even 0. And x varies from 0 to 3. So x varies from 0 to 3. Now here in this line integration, we need to see what is dl. So practically dl is dx into ix direction plus dy into iy direction plus dz into iz direction. But here if you observe this line, so that is varying along x direction only. So this dl that is dx ix only, where ix varies from 0 to 3. So if you do this line integration, then in this dot multiplication for this function f, only this coordinate is available with dot multiplication, as dx ix is there, other dot multiplication will be 0. So Here, this will be x varies from 0 to 3, and this will be x square y dx, right? And if you place y is equals to 0 in this, this entire term will get 0. So I'm saying this is 0 right now, right? Now, let us solve it for second line. So this is what second line. Let us say this is line number 2. Now in this line number 2, if you observe x is constant and that is 3. So x is equals to 3. So we can say dx is equals to 0. And here y varies from 3 to, y varies from 0 to 2. So y varies from 0 to 2. So we can say this dl, now see this line that is varying in y direction only. So I have to say this is what dy I y direction, right? So dl is dy I y. And if you do this dot multiplication, f dot dl, then in this you'll be finding only y component is there, and that is this x plus y square. So integration of y, integration of x plus y square with respect to y, where y varies from 0 to 2. And if you place x is equals to 3 in this, then 0 to 2, this is 3 plus y square dy. And if you do this, then 3 y plus y cube by 3, 0 to 2. And if you place limits, then you will be finding this will be 3 into 2, 6 plus 8 by 3. So 6 plus 8 by 3. So that is 3 into 6, 18 plus 8, 26 by 3. Now let us have third line calculation. So see, this is what third line which I am considering is line number 3. Right, so I am writing it first. This is line number 3. Now see, in this line number 3, x is constant and x is 2. So x is equals to 2, we can say dx is equals to 0. Sorry, here y is equals to 2. So y is equals to 2, dy is equals to 0. And here x is varying from 3 to 0. So here x is varying from 3 to 0. And here dl, that is dx ix. So if you do this line integration, f dot dl, so that will be x varies from 3 to 0, and x coordinate, that is x square y. So I'm writing it x square y dx. Now here y is equals to 2. I need to place this 3 to 0. Y is equals to 2 x square dx, and this 2 into x integration is x cube by 3. Limit is from 3 to 0. If you place 0, then that will be 0. And if you place 3, then that will be minus 27 by 3. So that is 9. So this will be minus 18. So third line integration, that is minus 18. Now let us consider fourth line. And that fourth line is this one. So this fourth line, in that if you observe, x is constant and that is 0. So here x is equals to 0, that is constant. So we can say dx is equals to even 0. And y varies from 2 to 0. So y varies from 2 to 0. And here dl, that is varying with respect to y axis only. So we can say dy into IY direction. Now if you calculate this integration, f dot dl, then that has to be y coordinate only, and y coordinate is x plus y square. So x plus y square dy, where y ranges from 2 to 0, where if you place x is equals to 0, this will be 2 to 0 y square dy, and integration of y square, that is y cube by 3, from 2 to 0, and if you place 0, that will be 0. If you place 2, then that will be minus 8 by 3. So total line integration, if you calculate this total line integration, then that is first line that is having 0, second line that is having 26 by 3, third line that is having minus 18, fourth line that is having minus 8 by 3. So see, this is what, minus 8 by 3 plus 26 by 3. So that is 18 by 3, that is 6. So 6 minus 18, that is minus 12. So if you see our previous calculation, so that was having answer minus 12. So we can say we have verified Stokes theorem. I hope that you have understood this. So whenever you will get this type of question, I consider you should solve it by having this curl and then dot ds. That will be easier one. In this, you will have to do multiple times line integration. That will be a bit complicated. So I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video.